I can't believe this is my first video. My YouTube has been years in the making. I've been talking about doing YouTube since I was 12 years old and I'm 24 now, so it's been a while. It's been on the cards for a while. But here we are, better late than ever. The world is on fire, so I said, let's go out with a bang. Literally. And today I'm taking you on my post-lockdown glow up. The day has finally come. Can we just, actually, I have the ugliest hands in the world. Like, hands down, no pun intended, ugliest hands in the world. Like, worse than Kim Kardashian's. So, these girls need help. So, yeah, today's video, I'm taking you on my journey, my glow up journey. So, I'm getting my nails done today. I'll take you on my haircut journey because I'm actually Rapunzel. Like, I could actually give Rapunzel a run for her money. I'm also going to take you shopping with me. I'll do a haul because I know I'll be buying lots and lots of things. And I'm also going to take you to my favorite restaurant when that opens up. So I'm so excited for today's video. It's my first one, so please bear with me. Cut me some slack. It is kind of awkward filming yourself, but like, I'm going to try my best. If you enjoyed, please give it a like or a comment. And if you want to see more from me, please hit subscribe. I'd love to have you watch my channel. So let's roll the clips and I'm excited. I'm so excited. Before I go, I'm in such a rush, but I'm gonna do a quick outfit of the day so you can see what I'm wearing. I mean, it's literally just a tracksuit, but I need to document. I woke up this morning and it was lashing rain. So I really had good intentions to dress up today, but I just cannot step outside in the rain in nice clothes. They'll just get ruined. Okay, so I'm wearing, first of all, my jewelry. I'm wearing these gorgeous little hoops from ASOS. Freckle check. So yeah, I'm wearing these gorgeous little hoops from ASOS. They are, I'll link everything down below, but these were like €7. Rock on, €7, I love it. Wearing these necklaces. My Gina one is from the M Jewelers and my sister got me this for Christmas. It's from Daisy Jewelry. It's Estée Lalonde. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right. Her line as well. I'll just leave everything down below if you even care. And my ring is a little pinky ring. Where's the camera? It's from, hello. Okay, this focus thing. It's from Ace Lee Clark. I got it a few years ago on BT. And I love her. I wear her all the time. So I'm wearing this little Sporting Rich jumper. I actually got it on Depop. Sporting Rich is quite expensive, but I got this for like half the price on Depop. So we love it. I'm wearing it with my Lululemon leggings. I mean, oh my God. My Lululemon leggings, a pair of white socks, and my New Balance runners. Ugh. Oh my God. I'll have to show you those in the mirror. And then I'm gonna throw on, because it's raining, I just have a feeling it's gonna be cold. And it's fully May, like it's fully May, and it's freezing. Like, I bring a hot water bottle to bed with me every night, so. Fun. I love it. I'm gonna throw on this like oversized blazer from Zara. It's got a cute little like cut out in the back. I'm probably not showing this very well, but we move. And then I've also got my little Bifur bag. Yes. it's really cute and sparkly. I got this on Best Year Collective. So quick story time. I got this on Best Year Collective. These bags retail for like, I'm gonna say 400 euro, if not more. This for 400 euro, I know. Anyway, so I was keeping an eye on like Depop, Best Year, which I love. And I saw people just selling theirs for like the same price, but secondhand. I was like, I'm not paying, like I'm just not paying that price. Some were up for 600 as well, which is just crazy. But anyways, I saw a girl selling it for 100 euro. So I had to get it. Let's just see if I've got my mask. Mask check. I'm fully always forgetting my mask, like running back. Oh my God. Okay, I just do one more story time. So yesterday I was going out for a little stroll and I like was looking at my post box because I'm expecting a ring from La Manso that I ordered 3.5 weeks ago and it still hasn't come. Cool. So I saw something in the post box and I was like, that has to be it. Like, surely I haven't ordered anything else. I'll get it on my way back. So on my way back from my walk, I obviously take out the post and I open it. It's my rape whistle. I ordered this in January, right? And I had already emailed the company being like, hi, I've not received this. Like, we're in May. We're in May right now. And they're like, yeah, it's gone missing. Sorry, we'll refund you. So I was like, okay, cool, whatever. I'll just get another one sometime when I care again, when I get scared again. And this was in the post. So happy Friday to me. I love being a girl. I'm actually not going to blow this ever. Because apparently it's like as loud as an ambulance. And I just, nobody needs to hear that unless it's an emergency. So, got my keys, got my whistle. She's got the mask. Yes. Yes. I don't know how tall girls do it. Like, I'm 5'3 and I can't even get myself in. Got the check. Bro, that's my YouTube career over, so. Not lying to you all, that mirror just fell on my head, so I'm literally shaking. Cool. Signs are pointing to me not to do a YouTube. That fully just fell on my head. Rock on. Anyway, the things we do. The things we do. My legs are shaking, but here we go. Here's the full outfit. I've got to go before something else tries to kill me, I swear. Oh my goodness. Okay, so first of all, I'm so happy to have my nails done. They're very cute. I get my nails done with Amy and Genevieve, and she's so good. I always just get a shellac with structure. The structure just lets me, like, it just keeps them on for longer. Like, I don't really fancy getting my shellac done every 2 weeks. I don't know about you, but I just don't have the time nor the money to do that. So I get the structure, I pay that little bit extra, and I usually get like 4 weeks out of them. And in total, that costs like 26.50, I think, which I think is reasonable enough. I don't know if I'm just like a crazy girl, but I love them so much. I just always get a little gold sparkle. I get the same every single time. Also, I just have the ugliest hands in the world, so can we just... I feel you judging. Stop. I have the ugliest hands in the world. They're like little man hands, but fuck it, girls. And yeah, I always get a little gold. I feel like gold just goes to everything. Like, I remember one time I got purple and I was like, zero, I can't wear anything because the purple doesn't go with any of my outfits. So I feel like gold is just, she She's consistent. She's a consistent girl. But yeah, I completely recommend going to Genevieve. I've been going to them for years, like for years to get this. And I'm so predictable. Amy was like, oh, so you're going with Gold again? And I was like, oh yeah. And she was like, cool, I have it already set up to go before I even came in. I was like, they're so predictable. And yeah, I'm so excited to finally just have my nails done. Like, I can't stop looking at them. They're so cute and pretty. And yeah, so that is the first little glow up that has happened to me. And I'm so excited to take you on my next one, which should be shopping. I'm gonna take you shopping next. Then we're gonna get the hair done. Then we're gonna go for food. And if I do anything else in between, I'll be sure to film. Day has finally come. We're hitting the shops. Woo. So excited that the day has finally come that I can go in to a store, touch clothes, see clothes, try on clothes. It's been far, far, far too long and I am so ready. It was like Christmas Eve last night. I couldn't sleep. I was like, I'm so excited to finally go shopping. We're doing it all. I'm hitting every single shop in Dublin. I'm going Grafton Street, I'm going Henry Street, I'm going to Connell Street. I can't think of any more streets with shops on it, but I'm gonna go there. I'm going to go there. When I was watching my video back, I was like, my nail reveal was just so anticlimactic, honestly. So, a fun little fact about my nails. I would love to get like the little designs, little squiggly lines, whatever. I can't. The nail techs say my nails are too small to do that on. A moment of silence for my baby nails. Help me. But anyways, we are back. We're going shopping. I am excited. So I am planning to take you to all my favorite shops, show you some bits I'm loving, what I'm purchasing, and also if I purchase anything, I'll do a haul. I'm not sure if it's gonna be in this video because editing it, I already feel like it's gonna be a really long one and I don't want it to be like a blockbuster movie. So I'm going to maybe do that in a separate video because I have actually bought some pieces before the shopping trip, obviously online, so I might throw them in to a little haul as well so you can see what I've been buying recently. But yeah, I'm gonna do a quick out of the day before I dash, before I go, before I Kardashian. So yeah, I actually had another little outfit planned, but the zip on the skirt bust. No more Marks and Spencer's bread rolls for me. Oh my God, I was editing this video earlier and I actually can't cope with this apartment. Like, it's so like not aesthetically pleasing. Like, look at the wood. For those wondering, I don't like this. I don't own this apartment. I'm just renting in Dublin. But it's so hideous. She's going down. I'm yelling timber. That's how I feel about this apartment. And also, I'm so aware that I cannot stop touching my hair in this video. It's just gotten to the point where it is too long and it like won't sit. So I need to keep like fixing it. So I'm so sorry if that is so annoying. That apology did not sound genuine, but it actually is. And also, I have Invisalign in case you're like, oh, she's got some cute teeth on her. It's Invisalign. Anyway, so my jewelry, it's the same jewelry as earlier on in this video. Same ASOS earrings, same necklaces, same pinky ring. But this, I'm so sorry. Mwah, this is beautiful. Again, we're gonna have to ignore my little studs. but it is just so gorgeous. I always thought I would not get on the like chunky costume jewelry trend. I didn't really like it, but I saw this on a girl called Megan Mullen. I'll tag her YouTube down below in my description. She is so gorgeous, has such an amazing sense of style, and does amazing videos. And she did a haul where she had this, and I was like, that's going right in my basket. That's going in my basket. Because wow. So it's from Lamanso, LA_MANSO. I'll leave it all down below. It was 69 euro and I think it came to like 77 with shipping. Now I have to say, I didn't have the best experience. It took a month for the ring to come. Online it says it should take 2 weeks. I'm just really like impatient, so I noticed, like, I just can't wait a month for something. If I ordered it, I just get bored then. I'm like, I don't want it anymore. And then they sent the wrong ring size. So that was really cute. They sent me a size small instead of a size medium. So ideally, I would have loved to have this on my like index finger, middle finger, just because I think it's a bit cooler. But I'm just going to have to leave it on my ring finger, unfortunately. I am going to bring it into a store, a little jeweler's, and see if they can like alter the size or like enlarge it for me, because I did want it for the index finger, to be honest. But it's fine, it's fine. It is gorgeous. The ring is called Total White. They do loads of other styles as well. There's a gorgeous pink one that I love. It's just I don't wear pink that often, and it is quite like, they are expensive, I have to say. But anyway, I absolutely love it. Do not come around me when I'm wearing this ring. If you put a toe out of line, when I'm wearing this ring, pow. It's over for you. Straight in the nose. Straight in the nose. Okay? Don't annoy me. Okay, quick outfit of the day before I go. I'm wearing this gorgeous co-ord from Jerf Avenue. It is a line by probably my favorite, I guess, influencer at the moment, Matilda Jerf. So gorgeous. The little tank top underneath is from there as well. I know I'm in another gray blazer. I do have other clothes, but I just really want to wear this because I haven't got the chance to yet. Looks so cute in my ring. For shoes, I'm wearing my cowgirl boots from Zara. I think they're really cute and add like a little cute touch to the look. And I'm also bringing my gorgeous Chanel jumbo bag. I love her. She has not got the use yet because obviously we are in a pandemic Lovato, but I'm gonna be bringing her out at any excuse. I'll probably just throw on my Celine sunglasses. I love these. I don't think they have a name, to be honest. Yeah, I'll have to find that out, but I love them so much. They're kind of like I guess an aviator style or a club master, not sure, but I love them and I'm in a huge rush, so I need to go. Come on, losers, we're going shopping. But they're far too long and they're a bit big. This is not a fashion piece, but I really wanted the Lululemon Define jacket for walking, exercising. I am just home and I am exhausted.
I don't even know how much I managed to film. When I tell you, town, like Dublin, was packed. Like packed. It was like Christmas time. It was honestly like Christmas Eve. It was such a hot day. I'm honestly never dressing up to go shopping again. Like, next time you see me shopping, I'll be in a tracksuit, because honestly, I swell when it's warm. So trying on stuff is actually just an ordeal. But other than that, I had a really good day. I didn't buy too much, actually. I wasn't really impressed with all the stuff that was in the shops at the moment. I feel like there was nothing really calling my name. I bought a few things, which I'm gonna do, like I said before, a separate haul video, because I also have ordered a few things that haven't come yet. So I'm just gonna like amalgamate the two and make a separate video. But overall, it was so fab to be in shops again, to see people I know, to just get dressed up, even though I just complained about it 2 minutes ago. But it was nice to like put on makeup, do your hair, have a nice day out. But hopefully next time I go, it's not as chaotic. Like, the combination of it being the first Saturday since shops have opened and it being such a sunny day, it was just mayhem. I feel really bad for sales assistants in shops. Also, if you're watching this, be nice to sales assistants, okay? I used to be one, and it's not a good time ever, let alone like in the middle of a pandemic. So watch your mouth. But yeah, I will obviously have a separate haul up letting you all know what I purchased, what I've been buying online. So watch out for that. I have another video that I've like planned coming up after this one. So it could be like the following video or the next one after that, but don't worry, it's coming. And if you're still watching this video, thank you so much for making it this far. Next on my hit list is my hair. Thank actual God. It's just so long and scraggly at this point, so I can't wait to get it done. And then I'm going for food in my favorite restaurant. Also, sorry about my makeup, like actually sorry about my makeup. I've been wearing a mask all day, so it's just taking it all off. But anyway, I'm gonna go and eat some dinner and get into my pajamas and throw my hair up in a bun and relax, because that was messy. Decided to cut this video here. This video is over now, because I was editing last night and it's coming up around 25 minutes, which I think is quite long for my first video, and I don't want to bore you all to tears. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to do a part two where I'm getting my hair cut and going to like a restaurant and whatever else I do. I'll probably go shopping again, to be honest, because that little clip you just watched was a fail, was an epic fail. So I'm so sorry for that. But I'll bring you shopping again with me in my part two. I'm just gonna quickly show you what I got yesterday. I literally got like four or five things, nothing major. But the first thing I'm wearing is this gorgeous ring from And Other Stories. It was 25 euro, and I feel like that's a really good price. Like, if you could feel this in person, it's so like chunky and like good quality. So I'm kind of into rings right now, in case you can't tell. But I just think it like kind of just jazzes up a whole outfit kind of. Gorgeous little top in Urban Outfitters. So I just thought it was really cute. I don't know why, I just like love the little cherries. But I just thought for summer, I say summer, we're literally coming into June, but I'm looking out and it's lashing rain, but maybe next year. Cute. I looked at it and thought, oh my God, I'm an extra in Stranger Things. I'm on my bike, it's the 70s. I'm wearing this with like some flares, my Converse, and I'm running away from the Demogorgon, right? Don't you see that for me? No, but I think it's really 70s and cute, and I don't know, it screams like Heim to me, or like, I don't know. I just probably wear it with some blue jeans and even shorts and my little cowgirl boots in summer. I think it's a cute little tee. And that was 29 euro and a size medium, and it's absolutely tiny, so size up. These Dr. Martens Adrian Tassel loafers with the black stitching. A moment of silence for these gorge shoes. They are sold out absolutely everywhere. I was on every app ever and nobody had them. I went in store yesterday and I saw them. and there were one pair left in my size. I knew it was a sign for me to get them. And these are a UK 3. I would recommend sizing down. They're very hard to get your foot into, I will say. Now, I have a super wide foot. It's like, imagine my hands, but they're my feet. That's what my feet are like. They're literally like just longer versions of my hands. This whole video I've just spent roasting my hands, and I'm like so sorry. Can we normalize chubby hands? Period. Done. But I picked these up. They are super tiny, but do size down because they will stretch. The leather is quite rigid and narrow, but once you get your foot in, they will stretch. So definitely size down. I've had my eye on these for a while now. I saw Emma Chamberlain wear them in one of her YouTube videos, and I was like, I need them. I need them. So easily influenced. Obviously, there was a huge like loafer trend there with the Prada loafers and the Chanel loafers, which I didn't like love. They're nice in some people, but I just wouldn't go out and buy them personally. I didn't think they looked their money's worth. But these I love. They are €169. The girl kindly gave me a student discount. So that made me happy. So they end up coming to like around €152 or something like that, I think. I know they're a little bit on the pricier side, but all the docs I have lasted so well. They're so worth their money. I'm also going to be wearing these to work. I work in the corporate sector, so I have to wear, you know, corporate wear, office wear, and I kind of really struggle with that. As someone who's like into fashion, I find it really hard to go into work in slacks. So I've been kind of rejigging my wardrobe to suit kind of like my style, and also going to work and buying pieces that I can wear outside of work as well, because I hate spending money on things that you can only wear to work. So I'm actually going to do a separate YouTube video styling some workwear pieces. But yeah, I'm going to wear these to work. I think they're workwear appropriate, in my opinion. And also just a pair of like blue jeans, black jeans, skirts, whatever. I just think they're so cute. Je love them. I picked up some underwear in Victoria's Secret. Nobody cares. Oh my god, such an anticlimactic haul as well. Was this Lululemon Define jacket? I really just wanted this for exercise. I go for a walk every single day on my lunch. Takes me like an hour. I'm like sweating, going fast because I hate running. I'm not a runner, I'm not a track star. But yeah, I thought it was really cute. A really good quality. Lululemon is the best. Invest in their leggings, invest in these things. You'll never have to buy something else. I have Lululemon leggings. And I've had another pair before, but I foolishly just bought some Gymshark stuff quickly because I think like Brian Thomas was closed. I wasn't into like ordering from the American Lululemon website and being charged customs. So I just ordered Gymshark and they're literally useless. Useless. Like on my walks, the like leggings are always falling down. The zip's broken something. So I was like, I need to just get this, get another pair of Lululemon leggings. And I also ordered a new pair of Asics last night online. She's a spendthrift. But that's everything I purchased. You also probably saw me try on those blue jeans and the black jeans in Brian Thomas. So the blue jeans are basically way too big of a size on me and too long. I'm 5'3" for reference, 5'3". And I'm like usually an 8 to 10 on the bottom and like a 6 to 8 on the top. Sometimes a 10, depending. But I tried them on and they were too big, and I've had my eye on them for ages. They're by the brand Shop Redone. But I actually ordered them last night online on Net-a-Porter. So they are coming. They will be in my try on haul. I hope they fit me because they were expensive. But I'm going to go into Brian Thomas actually today and pick up the black pair. They're also Shop Redone. I just really like them. I feel like it's really good to have like a good pair of jeans, just a pair of black and a pair of blue jeans in your wardrobe, like a capsule type of situation. So yeah, just so you know, I did actually end up ordering them online, and I'm going to go in and get the black pair today because I really like them. Redone are really expensive. Being honest with you, those jeans, the blue, are €280, and so are the black ones. They're €280 as well. Now on Net-a-Porter, they did like do a 10% off discount, so that was good. They end up coming to like €250 for some reason. And they don't charge customs, which is iconic behavior. And then in Brian Thomas, they're €280. So I'm gonna go and get those today. Gonna brave this terrible weather that's happening and get the black jeans. I have a few makeup bits to pick up as well, which will be in my haul, my upcoming haul. I just couldn't face going into the beauty rooms in Brian Thomas yesterday because they were just packed. I also did have my eye on a few things in Zara, but when I went into the store, they didn't have anything in stock. Like, I mean, every store didn't like have anything. I went to Victoria's Secret to get some nice underwear. They had like no pretty ones. I ended up getting a few pairs, but like they're just plain like nude and black. Zara didn't have anything in stock, nothing like that was on the app. Yes, I was kind of disappointed. But I did end up ordering the stuff from Zara online, so they will be coming as well. I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, please do give it a like. If you want to stick around for my part two, please subscribe. I have a little vlog coming up for my next video. It was just my dad's birthday and just what I was up to in kind of the months of April and May. And then I'm going to do the workwear styling and also just a haul of things I bought recently. So if that sounds like something you'd like to watch, please do subscribe. And if you all want to let me know what you think or what you'd like to see from me, do drop me a message. My Instagram is Gina's World with two S's, Gina's World. I picked that name when I was 13, so don't bully me about it. Thank you so much for watching. You are an icon if you've made it this far. Mwah.